Hello students, welcome to class 8th. Students, before I start with my lesson, I would like to talk to you. You know, these days are difficult for human beings on the globe. You might be feeling a little constrained as you would be instructed by your respectable parents to stay home. Dear and lovely students, you surely need to follow the instructions of the parents and government as at this tough time. But don't feel depressed and worried. The time will soon change, dear students. We are very much hopeful and optimistic citizens of India who believe that after each dark night, a glowing day full of hopes and dreams breaks out. We know ye waqt na thehra hai, ye waqt na theherega. Hence, change will soon come, so stay safe and stay healthy at your homes. Now let's start the topic of the day. I am going to take up the very first lesson of your supplementary book named It So Happened. And the very first chapter is How the Camel Got His Hump. You have to pay attention to my words, my voice, rather than to the pictures. Okay? Let's begin. Here I have prepared certain notes. You may look at them too. But simultaneously, you have to attend to my voice. You know, in the beginning, means when this earth has come into existence and the animals had just begun to work for man. At that very time, there was a camel who used to live in the howling desert, in the middle of the howling desert. Okay, howling, you know, howling, here H has been kept as capital, so it may be the name of some desert, but in other way. Howling has got a meaning. We can see the meaning too. Howling is mournful cry or a prolonged cry of distress. Okay, so he used to live in the howling desert and he didn't do any work. He used to eat sticks, thorns and prickles. Prickles are also thorns. And he used to say hum, hum, hum for anything which was asked to him. Now, what happened? A horse, you know, you can see here, a horse on a Monday morning came to him and the horse had come to him with a saddle on his back. You know, saddle is a kind of seat on the back of the horse for the rider. And he said, "Camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us." But the reply of the camel had been hum, means he denied to do any work, and the horse went back and complained the same to the man. After that, a dog came to him, and dog was carrying sticks in his mouth, and he also came to the camel and said, "Camel, oh camel, come and fetch and carry like the rest of us." But the camel had the same reply, hum, and the dog returned and complained to the man. After him, the ox came. Ox was carrying a yoke on his neck. You know, what is a yoke? Yoke. You can see here the meaning of yoke. A bar or a frame of wood by which two oxen are joined at the necks. Okay, that is called the yoke. So, he came to him and the ox came to him and said, "Camel, oh camel, come and plow like the rest of us." But the lazy camel had the same reply and he said, "Hmm." And ox returned and told the man the story. Now, the man called the ox, the horse, and the dog. Okay, here dog has not been written. Man called dog, the horse, and the ox, and he told them, three, I am very sorry for you, but Hump think in the desert cannot work, or he would have been here by now. So you all three must work double the time you may to make up for it. Means they were given the double work to make up for the work which was to be done by the camel who had not come there. Now all the three got very much angry. They got angry and they held a panchayat on the edge of the desert in the evening. Means at the end of the day, all the three held a panchayat. And then the camel came there. He was chewing the cud and he laughed at them, and he left their panchayat saying, "Hmm." Okay, he went away. When he did not agree with them, then what happened? When they all were there, all the three were there. Zin, you can see the spelling D-Z-I-N-N. The Zin, who was in charge of all the deserts, he came rolling in a cloud of dust. Okay, he came and they talked to him. Horse complained to the Zin, "Is it right for anyone to be idle?" Zin said, "Certainly not." Horse, "So if it is not right, then there is a thing in the middle of your desert with a long neck and long legs who does not do anything, means who has done nothing since Monday morning, and he won't trot." Means trotting, it's a movement of the horse. The jinn says, "I know who he is. He is my camel. What does he say?" Horse replied, he says humph. It is humphy written here. It is wrong. It's humph. He says humph. Then ox also complained, "He doesn't blow also." The jinn said, I will humph him if you will give me time of a minute." I will humph him means I will set him right if you will give me the time. So students, it was the first part of the chapter. You can see it is there in the picture in your book. Here is, you can see all the three animals, they are making a complaint to the man. And then here is the jinn with whom all the three, hawk, ox, horse and dog, making complaint. And here is the exercise for you to do for the first part. Here are the four questions. What task do you think were assigned to the dog and the ox? Why did the camel live in the middle of the desert? What made the dog, the horse and the ox very angry? How did the jinn know the horse was complaining against the camel? Okay, now let's move on to the second part. After listening to the complaints of the jinn, after listening to the complaints of all the three animals, that is the horse, the ox and the dog, the jinn, rolling himself up into a dust cloak and taking a walk across the desert, reaches the camel. Okay, cloak means loose and long garment, loose fitting long garment, a kind of dress. He reaches the camel, and at that very moment the camel was looking at his own reflection in the water of a pool. He was looking at his reflection in the waters of the pool and he was appreciating his charming looks. The jinn asked camel as why he was not working like other animals. And saying this, jinn sat down with his chin in his hand. But the camel, who was very much lazy and adamant too, we can say, the camel did not pay any attention to his words and kept on watching his own reflection in the pool of the water. Jinn again said, "Due to you, three other animals have to do extra work. all due to your idleness. Due to you, three other animals, who are they? They are animals. These animals are horse, ox, and the dog. They have to do extra work all due to your idleness. But the reply, you know, of the camel was, hum. The jinn said, if I were you, I had not given any chance to complain by anyone. Means I hadn't given the same reply if I were you. But here you are again committing the same mistake. You are saying the same words. But the lazy camel repeated the same hum. And very next moment, what happened, students? You know, his back of which he was so proud of. Means he used to appreciate his back very much. He was so proud of, started puffing up and up into a great big bump. Means his back started getting swelled. It swole and it became a great big bump. The jinn then said, do you see that? That is your own hump that you have brought upon your own self by not working. You know it is Thursday and you have not done anything from Monday when the work began. From last 3 days you are not doing anything. Now you are going to work. You will have to do the work now. Now what is the reply of the camel? Let's see. The camel says, how can I do anything with this hump on my back? The jinn then replied, that has got a purpose. This hump has got a purpose. Because you missed those 3 days. You will be able to work now for 3 days without eating. Because you can survive on your hump. And now, never complain that the jinn, did not do anything for you. Come out from this desert and go to the tree and behave properly with them. So in this way, dear students, the lazy animal, the camel, got the hump. Then the camel went away to join the tree. Right from that day, camel always bears a hump. Actually, we call it hump now, not to hurt him. If we say the same hump, then it will hurt his feelings. You may well understand. So it is hump now. But the camel could not complete his work of those 3 missed days. Till date, he has not completed that work of those 3 missed days. That is why he is carrying a hump on his back. Missed days at the beginning of the world, and he has till date not learned how to behave properly. So this was the story, chapter number 1. This chapter has been written by Rudyard Kipling. So you might have understood the lesson as well as the story, how the camel got his hump on the back. You can see here in the picture, you can see the camel is looking at his reflection and the jinn is asking him the reasons why he's not working, and then the story of his hump on the back. Okay, so now at the last, the questions for the second part are here. I'm going to read. The first is, the camel was looking at his own reflection in the pool. What does it suggest to you about the camel? Second question is, the camel said hum repeatedly. How did it affect him? Question number 3 is, what according to the jinn was the use of the hum? Question number 4, he has never yet learned to behave. In the light of this, what is the writer's opinion about the camel? So this was all about the story. First chapter, story of the first chapter, how the camel got his hump. I hope you might have understood this story. Now it's your work to go through the chapter at your home, and here you can have a look on the meanings of certain difficult words too. Okay, just see, you can note them down. Howling, mournful cry, prolonged cry of distress. Prickles, it's a small sharp pointed thorn. Saddle, a seat on the back of a horse. Yoke, a bar or a frame of wood by which two oxen are joined at the necks. Trot, it's also called gallop, galloping, it's a movement of the horse. And the clog, it's a long outer garment, that's a cloth. And on account of means, due to. Puff up means to swell. Bump means swelling on the skin. And hump means a rounded fleshy mass, such as on a camel. So you have to read the story first and then write down the meanings of difficult words. If you find any difficulty, you may make a call to me, and you have also to do the homework. The questions are to be answered, given and on at the end of both the parts, and that will be your homework. If you find any problem, you may make a call to your teacher. It is your teacher, Narinder Kumar, Pizzet English, Kendra Vidyalaya, Naleti. Good luck, be safe, stay healthy. Have a good day.